بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهداه وبعد. Honorable ulama and beloved brothers and listeners, الحمد لله, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon us this month of Ramadan. It is the month of the Quran, it is the month of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is the month of forgiveness, and we can carry on and on. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given it to us as a gift. We begin Surah Al-Fatiha, the beginning of the Quran, which is known as As-Sab'u Al-Mathani, the seven verses that are repeated time and again. We all know that in every salah we repeat Surah Al-Fatiha so many times. Similarly, in Salat Al-Taraweeh today we began with Surah Al-Fatiha. Every verse we read, we should know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds. The hadith says, قَسَمْتُ الصَّلَاةَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ عَبْدِي نِصْفَيْنِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, hadith Qudsi. He says, I have divided salah between myself and my worshipper. Two portions. Half is for myself, half for my worshipper. When a person says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, did we know that there is a response by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? My worshipper has praised me, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. My worshipper has glorified me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning. Maliki Yawm al-Din, my worshipper has declared my greatness. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'een, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is between myself and my worshipper. And for my worshipper is whatever he asks. And the first dua we make, Ihdina الصراط المستقيم, guide us to the straight path. This is the dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has requested, that this is the dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's divine wisdom has made us begin with. Subhanallah. So we should understand, wallahi, if we have guidance, we have everything. If we have no guidance, we have nothing. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us all. And we all know that dua continues. Surah Al-Fatiha. Then when we begin the next surah, Surah Al-Baqarah, we find Alif Lam Mim. These are known as huruf muqatta'ah, the separated letters, the letters which none knows the meaning besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And immediately after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is declaring the authenticity of the Quran. Look at those who have had the books before us, whether it is the Injil or the Torah. Today these books have been changed and none can prove the authenticity of these books. In fact, we can prove that these books are not authentic. This is as far as we can go. But we have the Quran. The first words Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. That book, speaking about the Quran, we can even say this book, meaning the Quran. There is no doubt in it. There are two interpretations of this verse, or maybe even more, but we will just mention two. This book, there is no doubt in it. That means it is authentic. Or we could say, لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. There is no doubt that in it lies guidance for those who fear, or who are conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who are conscious of their Creator. In it there is guidance. So the opening verses of Surah Al-Baqarah, we find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is declaring the authenticity of the book, as well as informing us that in this book there is guidance for those who are prepared to be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then mentions the believers And then he mentions the kuffar, and then he mentions the munafiqeen, the hypocrites. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst the believers and save us from the hypocrites. He says, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَمَا هُمْ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. From the people there are those who say we believe in Allah and we believe in the last day, but they are not believers. They are not believers either, their actions prove otherwise, or the underlying belief proves otherwise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to say that they are cheating none but themselves. يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَمَا يَخْدَعُونَ إِلَّا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَمَا يَشْعُرُونَ. They feel that they are cheating Allah, in fact, and they feel that they are deceiving Allah without Allah's knowledge. They are cheating Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the believers, but nay, they are cheating none other than themselves. If someone is a hypocrite, does it affect Allah? No, it doesn't. Does it affect the believers? No, it doesn't. Meaning it does not affect the iman of the believers. They are to be strong, but it affects themselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will get hold of such people. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from nifaq. Wallahi, hypocrisy is something very serious. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, as strong as he was still worried that whether he was a hypocrite or not. He used to ask Hudhayfa ibn al-Yaman, am I a hypocrite? Am I from amongst the names that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given you? And he used to say, no, your name is not there. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also keep our names away from such lists. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning, immediately after that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the greatness or the importance of the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the importance of staying away from shirk. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. O people, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who created you and created all those before you. And then thereafter Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning the gifts of Allah upon us, how He created the skies and the earth. وَلَا تَجْعَلُوا لِلَّهِ أَنْدَادًا. Thereafter He is saying, and do not associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from shirk. Then He begins to say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, in fact, He dares the people who claim that the Quran is not authentic, and He says, وَإِن كُنتُمْ فِي رَيْبٍ مِّمَّا نَزَّلْنَا عَلَىٰ عَبْدِنَا فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِّمْ مِثْلِهِ. If you are in doubt regarding that which we have revealed upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you are in doubt, then bring us one surah equivalent to it, similar to it. Wallahi, the kuffar of Makkah at the time have tried. Afterwards also they have tried. Nowadays also, if we search the internet, we will find sites of the kuffar whereby they have tried to write the verses of the Quran. Na'udhu billah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. If a person reads this, firstly his blood will boil. Secondly, he will understand immediately this is not the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They can never come with something as strong as the Quran. The Quran is the gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. And we, Ahlul Quran, wallahi, I always mention, if we were to remain in sujood our entire lives, wallahi, it would not do justice to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the sense that we would not do enough for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regarding or for the gift that He has given us. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to mention, He says, كَيْفَ تَكْفُرُونَ بِاللَّهِ. How is it that you can disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَكُنْتُمْ أَمْوَاتًا فَأَحْيَاكُمْ. And you were literally dead, you were not existent, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted you life. Every single one of us, were we not born? Before that, where were we? Is it not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who knows better than us where we were? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ثُمَّ يُمِيتُكُمْ ثُمَّ يُحْيِيكُمْ ثُمَّ إِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. Thereafter He will cause your death. Thereafter He will resurrect you and you will return to Him. Wallahi, each one of us needs to have yaqeen that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are going to return to Him. And we are answerable to Him. Every little deed of ours, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are answerable to Him. But if we are chosen, wallahi, the hadith says there are some worshippers whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant Jannah without hisab, without adab, straight through the green root, as it were. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst those. Ameen. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions how He created man. And He mentions in the first juz, inshallah, as the ajza go, we will mention that story in detail. Where Iblis alayhi la'natullah refused to prostrate to Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. Your arch enemy, O mankind, is Iblis. Iblis has promised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he will lead you astray. Yourself, myself. So we should understand. Let us not give him a chance. This is the month of opening of the hearts. Let us wallahi open our hearts, make friends with those Muslims that we might have had difference of opinion with, or we might have had ill feeling against. We should always check our hearts. Let us clean our hearts of all ill feeling, for indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive us if we forgive others. There is a greater likelihood of us being forgiven if we forgive others. If we are to be hard and fast, who knows, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might also cause us, may He save us, but He might cause us to stumble because we were hard and fast, so now He wants to also practice the same up against us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. He is much more merciful than we can imagine. Wallahi, He is much more merciful than we can imagine. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions or warns those who encourage others to do good but forget themselves. He says, أَتَأْمُرُونَ النَّاسَ بِالْبِرِّ وَتَنْسَوْنَ أَنفُسَكُمْ. Is it that you are ordering people to do good and you are forgetting yourselves? Nay, that is something we should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from. Ordering and commanding people to do good, we should firstly look at ourselves as well. Are we guilty of not fulfilling the same that we are calling for? If that is the case, then we are being hypocritical. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from that. Then we have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioning the story of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Ajib. The first juz, the first para, and here we have the story of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Towards the end of the para, we have mention of so many other anbiya alayhim salatu wasalam. Allahu Akbar Kabira. This is ishara. This is a little sign to the people of the book to say, those who follow Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, wallahi, the Muslims also believe in Musa alayhi salam. Those who follow Isa alayhi salam, wallahi, the Muslims also believe in Jesus, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. So this is an ishara towards that as well. The story of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam is mentioned very briefly, and there is one particular incident that is mentioned in great detail, the story or the incident of the Baqar. The Baqara meaning the incident of the cow. That is a long story, and I ask you to go home and read that story. If we do not already know it, we should go home and read it. Just before the half point of the first juz, there is an interesting incident regarding a cow Banu Israel was told to slaughter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make us like amongst the people of Banu Israel and like them. May He not make us like them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to mention magic and the fact that a person who deals in magic in any way, he is a kafir. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. The Quran says, وَمَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانَ وَلَكِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ كَفَرُوا يُعَلِّمُونَ النَّاسَ السِّحْرِ. It was not the accusation. It was not that Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam disbelieved, but shaitan disbelieved by teaching people magic. My dear brothers, dear listeners, anyone who associates with magic, with any form of magic, from a distance or from near, wallahi, it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we ask to assist them and to assist us. They are selling their iman with something else. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and our offspring, our families and all the Muslims from this evil and this ill which leads to kufr and disbelief. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala thereafter mentions the kuffar, and He says regarding Ahlul Kitab, وَدَّ كَثِيرٌ مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ لَوْ يَرُدُّونَكُمْ مِّنْ بَعْدِ إِيمَانِكُمْ كُفَّارًا حَسَدًا. Many of the Ahlul Kitab, many of the Ahlul Kitab, they would love to turn you back from your iman to kufr. حَسَدًا. حَسَدًا means jealousy, out of jealousy. They know we accept Musa alayhi salam, we accept Isa alayhi salam, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They only accept either Musa alayhi salam as well as Isa alayhi salam, but they don't accept Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wallahi, I am telling you here and today, it burns them that we believe in Musa alayhi salam and Isa alayhi salam. And they continue to struggle and strive to tell their people that, look, the Muslims don't believe in Isa alayhi salam. It is not the same Isa. Na'udhu billah. It is exactly the same Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, but the beliefs we have are authentic. They are the same in the entire Quran if you search cover to cover. Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam. When we speak of Isa alayhi salam, we all know exactly whom we are speaking about. But speak to them, they don't know. One will tell you thalithu thalatha, one will tell you he is part of a trinity, the other will say he is not part of a trinity. So themselves, they are confused. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us, guide them as well. Grant them hidayah. Wallahi, this should be our dua. Then we have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioning for the first time in the Quran, وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ. Establish salah and give zakah. Inshallah, we will come to the details of this as the days go. Later on, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the second para regarding the Qibla. The Qibla from Baytul Maqdis, it was turned to the Haram in Makkah, to the Kaaba. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned this at the beginning of the second para. And after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again tells us about salah. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu ista'inu bis sabri was salah. Seek help. Seek assistance through salah. You want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you? Salah. Salah. Perform wudu and fulfill salah, whether it is nafila, farad, whatever it is, you will find if you read it correctly, you will have a peace in your heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open the doors. And thereafter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us to eat halal. He is telling us that we should refrain from haram. And inshallah, as the days go, we will find further verses in the Quran which have warned us to stay away from haram. Today, unfortunately, many of us, na'udhu billah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. We are not very, very particular regarding what we eat, what we consume, regarding what we earn. Is it halal? Is it haram? Where does it fall? What category does it fall under? Wallahi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has warned us. Ya ayyuha an-nasu kulu mimma fil ardi halalan tayyiba. O people, eat that which is halal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon you. Wala tattabi'u khutuwati ash-shaytan. Do not follow shaytan. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding of these verses. What we have done, we have selected very few verses to interpret. Inshallah, we will find that we will be reading 1.25 juz for 4 days. Thereafter, we will cut down to 1 juz. It will give us a little bit more time, inshallah, to explain a few of these selected verses from the Quran. We all know that the Quran is so vast. It is impossible for us to sit here and in a few minutes explain to you exactly what was read. But just a few selected verses, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept them from us. May He grant us the understanding. May He grant us hidayah. May He grant us the opening of the month of Ramadan with open arms. May He forgive us. And may He grant us the acceptance in this month. May He forgive us. May He forgive all the marhumeen. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower upon us the light of this month and the noor. Wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.